Wait, sorry, you're... How many? More than 10? Including what? Crystal Beard Aragon? No, cancel the whole order. The nerve of some people. Ladies, gentlemen, and monsties of all ages, we could have had more monsties. I guess that statement is always true, though. They could put 1,000 monsties in and it could technically have more. But I'm not talking about drawing wild conclusions here or bringing up every creature under the sun. Today's Monstie focus is very specifically about two games that aren't Monster Hunter Stories. Two games which are often actually called spin-offs of Monster Hunter Stories, which is, of course, a spin-off of the mainline Monster Hunter games itself. So today we are looking at the spin-offs of the spin-off, and I feel like I am at least 60% insane saying that statement. The specific games that I'm referring to are a puzzle game called Monster Hunter Stories Monstie Drop, and a gacha game called Monster Hunter Riders. I refer to them as Stories spin-offs because, well, one of them literally has Monster Hunter Stories in the name, and the other heavily features Riders riding Monsties. So, you know, yeah, these games are undeniably connected to Stories. Add that on to how incredibly similar the art style looks in these two stories too, and it starts to seem reasonable to think that anything in these games very much could have been in Stories 2 upon release. Now, I'm not saying that we are owed these creatures or that we should have had them or anything of the sort, just talking about the interesting concept that these games added models for what essentially are monsties, in many cases even actually having saddles on the creatures, and that if they wanted, I'm sure that the team that made Stories 2 could have dropped a hand over and borrowed these models to turn into a fully fledged creature in Stories 2 itself. These are all monsters that I can show you pictures of that look directly taken out of Stories 2. That's how similar the art style is, and that is why we're here. Not to be sad that we don't have these, because we're not really entitled to them, but to be curious about things that could have happened. I will say that both of these games are entirely unavailable in the West currently, so if you were hoping to play them, sorry about that one. And while some of these monsties like Crystal Beard Aragon may not be heavily missed, sorry Crystal Beard, but I'm sure you would have been very heavily collected by people, there are definitely some people that you would have wanted to be taken by, but there are absolutely some creatures that you probably would appreciate more than him. So why not start with one of the main culprits here, Valstrax. Yeah, full-on Valstrax had his model in Monster Hunter Stories Monstie Drop, and well, let's just say if he made it into Stories 2, I doubt there would be any wild Valstrax left, because every single one of them would find a home in someone's stables. He is one of the most popular monsters of all time, and just knowing that he could have been in the game is pretty cool. I suppose we always have the possibility of DLC release in the future, and nothing here is off limits when it comes to DLC. But I won't pretend to not be excited about the concept of a Valstrax Monstie. I really think that that would have been an awesome thing to have. Crystal Beard, who I mentioned before, is a Deviant, which before the game actually came out, I would have said is super unlikely to be in Stories 2, but well, now Stories 2 is out, and it actually has Deviants as one of the main endgame focuses, so Crystal Beard doesn't seem quite as ridiculous to me now as he did a couple of months ago. On a similar wavelength, though, we also have this model for Deadeye Yongaruga, though, to be real with you, every Yongaruga in Stories 2 sort of looks like they're a Deadeye Yongaruga, so I don't really know what's up with this one long term, but Monstie Drop had a Red Helm Arzoros, and as someone who very much likes bears, I would not have been against bringing beefed up Arzoros around with me in the slightest. I would have very much enjoyed that. Past that, we wander into some more interesting territory, though things not even remotely touched in Stories 2 so far, starting with Variants. Savage Devil Joe, who is of course the super version of Devil Joe. To be fair, balance-wise, Devil Joe doesn't really need a super strong version in the game at the moment. He's already pretty damn okay when it comes to dragon monsters. And then Raging Brachydios, who again, regular Brachy, is one of the best fire monsters in the game, but it would be awesome to have Raging there too. He does have a lot of differences and he could be represented differently with different abilities that would be fun to mess with. New genes to put into the pool, you know? There are also models for some rare species in these games too. In Abyssal Legiacris, who would be straight up awesome to have as a lightning monstie, and Lucent Nargacuga, who is just the best Nargacuga. Sorry, Silverwind. This is an interesting moment to go back to the notion I brought up earlier of things being added as DLC in the future, potentially. I was talking about Valstrax at that moment, which could be quite a significant undertaking for the devs to make come together, well, you know, at least compared to something like a variant or rare species of a Monstie that's already in the game, wouldn't it? I could totally see them doing an update down the line with some things like Savage Devil Joe and Raging Brachydios, things like Lucent Nargacuga and Abyssal Legiacris. That feels perfectly in line with our update so far. I'm looking at you, Hellblade Glavinus and Bolt Reaver Asilos. I'm just saying, none of this is quite off the table of being possible yet. Before getting into the real meat of the meal here, though, I will make the passing point that the Monsties for Plesioth, Egnactor, and Glacial Egnactor are in these two games, and didn't make it to Stories 2, but I've already talked a fair amount about my thoughts on these Monsties not making it into Stories 2, so I'll just leave that as a passing mention that their models are also in these two games here. The real thing to talk about, though, that we have left is Rise Monsters, or I guess ideally, Rise Monsties, because two creatures from Monster Hunter Rise have already been added to Monster Hunter Riders as a collaboration event, and their models look incredibly capable of jumping straight over to Stories 2 one day. Of course, there is the one that you would probably expect, the flagship himself, Magnamalo, who looks just lovely as long as you consider the screaming souls of the damned to be lovely. I'd enjoy having him around personally, he'd be a pretty fun one. But the one that makes me most excited personally, just the base concept of this could have happened, is Tetranadon. Yeah, they put Tetranadon in Monster Hunter Riders, and he looks absolutely adorable in this art style. How cool would it have been to ride a Tetranadon into battle? And that is why I'm holding on so hard to the concept that these are still maybe on the table for DLC in the future. In theory, Story still has quite a bit of DLC to release over time, and I would say that every single monster that I have talked about here is on the shortlist for potential additions after this current DLC roadmap ends and we enter a new cycle. And I'd have no complaints about any of these creatures coming, unless we get an update that is literally only Crystalbeard Aragon by himself. But Capcom isn't that much of a troll, right? Right? Alright everyone, that'll do. A nice little chat about some monsters who didn't quite get themselves ported into Monster Hunter Stories 2, regardless of being in some Monster Hunter Stories spin-offs games. A curious inspection of what didn't come to be, and what could potentially be laying in our future. Do you wish that you could ride any of these creatures? Are there any monsters that you'd love to see that I didn't even talk about here? Like if you liked the video, subscribe to the notification bell for more, and most importantly, ladies and gentlemen, until next time, stay sweet.
Josh, Cotton, and Hollow with the videos, dropping the humor like a hammer on your tippy toes, bringing entertainment on a daily arrangement to take our insanity and turn it into entertainment.
Yes, I said entertainment twice, to reiterate that it is nice to look into your faces on a mostly daily basis when you let us in your homes to make the whole world our stage. Goodbye.